Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn the new chapter, Human Diversity in Civics. What is human diversity? Look around you as you sit in class. Each one of you is different from the other. Some differences are obvious, like some of you are boys, some of you are girls, and some of you have long hair while some have it short. Some are short while some are tall. These differences you can make out at a glance, but there are other differences like the language we speak at home, or the religion we follow, or the kind of food we eat to like to eat, or the kind of music we enjoy. These differences might be less obvious, but they are equally important in making each of us what we are, unique human beings. This state of being different, of being unique, is known as diversity. Diversity includes such factors as age, gender, ability, race, religion, education, occupation, and food. Diversity need not mean that each of us does different things all the time. Very often we might be doing the same thing, but we just do it differently. Thus, we all eat, but some of us eat with our hands, while some use forks, some use knives or chopsticks. Most of us read, but some like to read comics, while some like to read storybooks. Many pray, but some of us go to the temple to pray, while some of us go to the church. Some prefer to pray at home, and we all speak to communicate. We just use different languages to do so. The need for diversity. Diversity, or the variety, is one of the most beautiful aspects of life on earth. No two humans are alike, just as every snowflake that falls on earth is shaped differently. Just as diversity is beautiful, it is also very necessary. We need this diversity. Humans have different skills. Some people are skilled carpenters, while some prefer to be teachers. Some build aeroplanes, while some prefer to fly those aeroplanes. And if everyone had the same skill, so could we survive? No. Humans with diverse interests and skills are necessary for the society. Diversity also enriches our lives. Imagine if you had to live in the world of identical people, everyone would look the same, dress the same, talk the same, and behave in the same way. Would you like to live in such a world? When you live with a diverse group of people, you learn from them. You absorb different cultures. You become more tolerant and broad-minded. India, unity in diversity. India is one of the most diverse countries in the world. India here to a civilization that is more than 500 years old. Different groups of people from different places of the world migrated to India over the years, adding to its richness. Today, India is a land of varied cultures, religions, and communities. More than 1,600 languages are spoken here in India. A wide range of ethnically different people populate our land. We find people following different customs, traditions, and lifestyle. However, despite all this diversity, the different styles in dress, food habits, language, and culture, there has always been interaction, exchange, and an underlying unity among Indians. So now we'll learn the characteristics of India's diversity. The wide diversity seen in India can be studied under the following heads. The first one, economic inequality. The second one, social diversity, and the regional diversity. Economic inequality. India has some of the richest people in the world. India's economy is booming and the people are earning more money than ever before. There are people in India who can own several cars, who spend their vacations in expensive places. But sadly, India has some of the people, poorest people in the world, according to the government of India. In 2011 and 12, 27.5% of the population of India lived below the poverty line. So what is poverty line? The poverty line is the minimum level of income needed to achieve an adequate standard of living as per the government of India. The poverty line for the urban area is ₹672.8 per month, in rural areas, and 859.6 per month in the urban areas per day. Now we'll move on to social diversity. India is a country plagued by social differences, the caste system which has existed in India for almost 2000 years. This has created the several unequal divisions in the society. And there are hundreds of castes and subcastes in India today. People are identified according to caste which they belong. Apart from this, another example of the social differences that exist in India, the family system that we practice. Many of us live in large families consisting of grandparents, uncles, aunts and cousins. This is the joint family system. Some of us live only with our parents and siblings, means brothers and sisters. This is known as a nuclear family. And this social diversity is also seen in the variety of religions practiced in India today and the celebrations of their respective festivals. Dasara, Muharram, Christmas, Diwali, Buddha Jayanti and Jasmith Nowruz are observed by people of different faiths in the spirit of harmony. Some social customs and festivals are typical of a particular region. For example, Pongal is celebrated in Tamil Nadu. The cattle fair is celebrated annually in Puskar and Rajasthan, and Bhogali Bihu is celebrated in Assam. The different classical dances forms Bharatanatyam, Kathak, Odissi, Manipuri, right? And traditional folk dances provide a colorful spectrum of Indian culture. So we'll stop here and I hope you understood, and we'll learn more in the next class. I have asked you a few questions on this. You can read the lesson once again, then answer.